Gather round, everyone, and hear again the tale of Drakfu. Welcome back, everybody, and happy Friday. The weekend is almost here. The podcast is almost ready to go, which is funny because today we're technically going to be having two podcasts going up. Didn't really plan that out, though. Well, I did plan that out fairly well because, well, today's a very special day. Because a very unique movie came out today. But that's not why you guys are here. You guys are here for some tale of freaking Drakfu. So let's go ahead and continue our questing in the Storm Peaks. So right now we are continuing to make ourselves or befriend ourselves with the Sons of Hodir. Oh, sorry. I'm sure people want me to stop that, but it can't be done. It can't be done, man. Can't be done. So first of all, we're going to do the Stormforged Eyes that we need to get. Die! Give me all your Stormforged Eyes. This might actually take a while. Do I get anything from the Brittle Revenants? No. Because I gotta go over there, over there, over there. Here we go. Oh, that's right. Okay, it's kind of random on when you get them, but yeah, all you have to do is use this pick with the dead iron giants that are here, and either you will get eyes or you will get attacked and the enemies will give you eyes. So this is going to be interesting. I'm right between a couple of brittle revenants. Oh no. Speaking of, so a lot of people didn't actually notice this. This is actually the new design for elementals, at least in in Northrend. And eventually we do get other versions in Cataclysm. So that's another thing that kind of happened throughout. Mists of Pandaria, no, they had a unique take on elementals too. Same thing with Warlords of Draenor. And not really, I don't think there's really been a change in Legion, but that's just because there's other types of enemies to take on. So, okay. Here's the trick for this part, though. So we're in this battlefield, and we actually need to look for horn fragments. But while we're here, you can see that there's a bunch of enemies. So we'll be taking care of them as we go along. Normally, I would questing break this, but I think we're early enough in the episode that we'll be okay, and it won't take that long. So once again, happy Friday, everybody. As something to put in the comments this week, I'd actually like to know how many of you guys are going to go and see the new Power Rangers movie that launched today. I'd be very interested to see how many of you guys are actually going to go see it. For those who are already asking, are we going to be doing a review for Power Rangers? Yes, but we're actually going to hold, the podcast is going to hold off for a week to give people time to go see it. And then we will do a group review of it next week.
But Drak, that's not a good idea. Then all the other reviews will be out.
Well, unfortunately, we don't really have that much of a choice. Unfortunately, a couple of us work 9-to-5 jobs, so they already wouldn't be able to see it before the podcast. And the other ones are going to be fairly busy on that day, too. So we're just going to wait a week, and we're also going to do that with... because next week, Ghost in the Shell launches. We're going to hold off for a week on that as well, and then do a group review on Ghost in the Shell. The other question that people did ask is, like, are we going to go together to go see it, like we've said on other podcasts? Unfortunately, we can't make that work this time. So we will all go and see it on our own spare time, and then we will come together to do a review. That's just unfortunately how it worked out this particular week. Not sure about Ghost in the Shell just yet, but... it's entirely possible we won't be able to get together for that either. Because sadly, life must go on. That is the reality of life, is that life must go on. Okay, so now that we have both of these done, let's go ahead and turn these into the Sons of Hodir. Never get tired of doing that. And down here, and here is King Joachim. So let's go ahead and turn in his quest. Who's the other guy that needs it? Is it just King Joachim, or do we have another guy? Oh, and you'll notice we actually got another daily opened up, which is the Frostwarg Den Mother, and that's another thing you can do for the Sons of Hodir. So let's go ahead and turn this in. In memoriam. Have you found the pieces of Hodir's horn? Yes, we have.
another good deed you have done on Thorim's behalf, monk. This will help soften the hearts of my people towards him.
Okay. And a monument to the fallen.
Bring these fragments to Njormeld. He will use the pieces of that sacred relic in the construction of a mighty monument. May it soothe the pains and heal the scars my people have borne these many years. May its presence help to bring about a new age that sees us once again in glorious battle at Thorim's side. Go now, monk. Njormeld awaits you.
Alright, so we need to go meet with Njormeld. And who was the other guy that needed ancient relics? Who needed that? Was it Thorim? Ancient relics. Yeah, it might. Oh, no. Ancient relics. I'm looking at the wrong one. My bad. So, okay. Here we go. And there we go. Forging ahead. So let's get that done.
Have you collected the final components I seek, Blood Elf?
Yes, we have. We have 8 eyes.
It is nearly done. With this artifact in place, Dunnifilim shall be warned of impending dangers before they are even upon us.
Okay, and mounting Hodir's helm.
The helm is forged. Your efforts have not gone unnoticed, small one. Though there remains much to do, we Sons of Hodir are grateful for your accomplishments. In return, I offer you the opportunity to present Hodir's helm to our king and our brethren. Fly to the sparkling tip of the small ice spike in front of me and read to our people from this tablet. Enjoy the privilege, monk. Never before has an outsider been given such an honor.
Okay, so we have that, and then we also have Monument to the Fallen.
You have brought the fragments of Hodir's horn, little Blood Elf.
Yes, I have. I was told to.
Njormeld's eyes become noticeably moist as he pours the contents of the bag onto the anvil.
The horn of Hodir. This was a sacred gift to our people from Hodir himself. Blood Elf, it is a relic of great importance to us. When you next return to our stronghold, you shall see the fruits of your labor. Farewell.
Basically saying that it will phase again. And I'm trying to think, which one was it that I needed to mount? Oh, probably the one that's shining. So you go over to this spike right here, and then you read the tablet.
Sons of Hodir, I humbly present to you the helm of Hodir.
There you go. Wonderful performance, Drakfu. Wonderful.
Thank you, I tried.
Okay, Njormeld.
We've done as you asked, we mounted the helm.
Njormeld gazes upon Hodir's helm, visibly moved.
That will do, little Blood Elf. That will do.
That'll do, pig. That'll do. Okay, so we now have that done. And again, another quest that you can get, which is actually... I gotta show this, because... Oh, man. Some of these quests. Seriously. Polishing the helm. Thrusting the spear. Let's see. I can't remember what the Den Mother's quest was. Spy Hunter, that's not one that is relevant. People might notice the blue question mark right there, too. He is actually who you could turn in Relics of Ulduar to gain Sons of Hodir rep. And we actually will take advantage of that, but we still have a quest that needs to utilize Relics of Ulduar. After that, we'll turn them into him. Because I think you have to be a specific rep before they'll even give you the finish-up quest. Yeah, Hodir's tribute, so we're not going to worry about that. Is that it? Is that all the quests we got? That can't be it, but I'm actually wondering if maybe we have to be revered to get the remaining one. How many relics do we have? We have 24, so let's actually turn some of these in and see what happens. Hodir's tribute. Yes, 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 yes. We want to give you 10 Relics of Ulduar, and that gave 325 rep. Not enough. So that was not helpful. Okay, we might actually need to come back to this later. Let's see. Oh, we need to take the armor back to Thorim. I forgot about that. We have the reforged armor. So let's go ahead and take that back to Thorim, and for that, I'm going to magic cut while we fly there. Alright, we are back at Thorim's tower. Let's go ahead and give the armor to Thorim, and hopefully this will forge a new alliance between the Sons of Hodir and Thorim.
Ulduar is lost, my beloved slain. What is left for me here?
Thanks, Thorim. Appreciate it. How have your efforts fared, monk?
I have some new armor for you.
As you present Thorim with a reforged suit of armor, he is visibly stricken by its splendor.
You have done well, Blood Elf, but there remains much to be done.
Okay.
Varinus, if I'm to launch an attack against my brother's army, I'm going to need some way to get around. Because, you know, even though I look like a god, I'm kind of not. I released my riding drake back into the wilds years ago. Varinus was magnificent, the leader of her own brood, to whom she has now returned. Finding her will be hard, but perhaps there is a way. She keeps her old empty nest out of pure pride. She's a brood mother and name only, for she is beyond the age of breeding. Bring me small eggs from the other nests near Brunhildar. I think I have an idea.
Okay, so we need some small proto-drake eggs. And actually, no, this is going to continue things on, but we will get Sons of Hodir up, I think, while we do it. Yeah. Did we get one for... No, we didn't get one for New Beginning, but we might get one for Varinus' eggs. And Varinus is actually an important character as well, because, like you said, it's his riding drake, or at least he wants to reclaim Varinus as his riding drake. And when you actually go into the raid of Ulduar... Varinus has actually undergone some horrible changes and has become the boss Razor Scale. At least that's the way... Yeah, I think it is Varinus. So you can actually face her as a boss in Ulduar, and it's kind of sad when you actually know who that is. Especially considering the... And we'll get into that lore in Dungeons and Drakfus, trust me. That will happen. Okay, so there's three... We just need two more. Gotta be another nest nearby. Nope. Oh, yep, there you go. Except this one is actually filled with proto-drake hatchlings. So we'll take care of them too. Sorry, buddy. There we go. So last egg. And now let's fly back up to Thorim. Boom. There we go. And this will help us summon Varinus so that he can reclaim his... So Thorim can reclaim his mount. And people are actually asking, as of Wednesday's episode, like, where are we at in the questing? You can see it right here. It's just, when I have too many quests, it doesn't show up. We're halfway through the zone. And I'm thinking... Given the pace that we've been going, we'll probably be 3/4 through the zone by the end of this week, and we'll start Ice Crown next week. And Ice Crown is the last zone of Wrath of the Lich King. Then we can move on into Cataclysm, and hopefully that won't take as long, but right now my biggest concern is we're going to be like 85 by the time we get to Cataclysm. So, yeah. Seems to be the way things are going.
Thorim, we're back!
Hail, tiny creature. Did you obtain the eggs, Drakfu?
I did.
Yes, these will do. Let us hope my plan works, Drakfu. Varinus is a great drake. I'd hate to have to settle for a lesser one.
Alright, territorial trespass.
Varinus is proud like no other beast I've known. She still keeps her old nest and makes sure none of the elder of the younger proto-drakes take it over. Take the eggs you've collected and place them on her nest. You'll find it atop a small peak directly southeast of here. I should be able to get control of her before she kills you in a fit of rage. Hopefully.
That's already very worrisome, Thorim, but okay, we'll do what you asked. Now, the other thing I also want to keep track of is that we are right... Oh, no crap. Oh, boy. This is not going to end well. Oh, boy. Okay. We're gonna die. We're gonna die. That should not have left a body. That should have been paste on the ground. All right, we'll be right back while we get back to the body. Thankfully, I wasn't too far off. All right, so now that we've taken care of that, I also want to pay attention because I'm right in the middle of the path of a particular... NPC called the Time Lost Proto-Drake, and if I would actually find it really funny if I found it on the stream, and then people could get horribly mad with me that I did that. I'm not even gonna I'm not even too worried about it, but it would be funny if we actually did find it, because you can get the chance for a mount from it. Okay, so this is the Broodmother's Nest. All you have to do is put down the Protodrake eggs, and... All right, where is she? There's Varinus. Ah, Varinus! While you're landing, I'm just gonna look around. Yeah, no. Probably not gonna happen. The Time Lost Protodrake has a horrible spawn rate, so... I'm not expecting to find this thing. It would be funny, though.
I can't attack that.
Alright, so Varinus is just doing her thing.
I can't attack that target.
And, uh-oh. I think if we... I gotta get the... Oh, there it is. So, we actually missed it, but Thorim actually jumps down from his tower. Look out below! So now he has Varinus again. Varinus lets out a bellowing roar as she descends upon the nest. Easy there, girl! Don't you recognize your old master?
I thought we had a mutual parting, man. I will see you at the Temple of Storms. Looks like I'm going to have to break her in again.
You have a good luck with that, dude. I do not think she's going to get broken in anytime soon. But there you go. So, I think, yeah, we just go back up to the temple. Again, it'd be really funny if I found it. Be really funny, because... I don't know about on the server that I'm actually doing this, because again, this is a random assortment of servers, but I know people who, like, literally can't the Time Lost Protodrake and still have not found it. And Wrath of the Lich King is back from 2008, so they've been farming it for better part of 8 years. Here we go.
Oh, you finally broke her in, I guess.
What are you doing in the mountain?
It's good to have my old friend back. It appears that my luck is finally starting to change. And it's all thanks to you, little friend.
Okay.
Krolmir, Hammer of Storms. One task remains before I can reclaim my home at the Terrace of the Makers. Krolmir must be found. On that fateful day, I threw it to the earth with all the power and rage I possessed. A mighty explosion followed. I've thought it lost for these many years, but now I must be certain. Return to King Joachim and discover what, if anything, he knows of my hammer's fate.
Okay. So let's go ahead and take care of that. And for that, let's go ahead and do a quick magic cut while we fly back to Dun Niphilim. Okay, we are back in Dun Niphilim, and here is King Joachim. So let's go ahead and talk to him. Now, people might notice that Krolmir actually does have a rep requirement. You need to at least be friendly with the Sons of Hodir. So back then, this wasn't as generous with the rep as it is now. But thankfully, I'm honored, so I don't necessarily need to worry about that. So King Joachim will answer my questions.
Hi, King. You are permitted to visit our stronghold, little blood elf. Yes, we know.
If it please you, King Jakob, may I know what has become of Krolmir?
Very well, little monk. While there is much left for you to do to mend our relations with Thorim, I am compelled to share with you this one secret. Speak to me again when you are ready to be shown that which you seek.
I am ready to be shown the fate of Krolmir.
Alright, so he basically takes us.
Hold on, little blood elf.
And I'm on top of his head, in case you couldn't tell. Funniest thing, where we actually were getting the horn fragments, is I think where Thorim struck the ground with it and the mighty explosion happened, because I believe all the frozen frost giants are actually Thorim's fault. I might be wrong, but I think that's right. Okay, Joachim, you can move faster than this. I know you can. Maybe we need to get you on a diet. So here you are, that all of the frost giants that have been frozen in place for many, many, many years, and their spirits haunt the land.
Thorim, come show yourself!
And there is Thorim. I'm going to try and get them both in focus, but yeah, it's kind of hard. There it is.
King Joachim, you have summoned me? The deeds of your blood elf servant defy his stature, Stormlord. His efforts have succeeded in softening the hearts of my people. Joachim, son of Arngrim, I have always regretted my actions here. In my grief, I brought great harm to those closest to me. I would ask for your forgiveness for the suffering I have caused you and your people. Never has such humbled words come from the mighty Thorim. I shall deliver your words to Dun Niflheim. The events of that dark day are hereby forgiven by my people. They shall never again be spoken of.
Okay.
To signify our reforged friendship, I have something which belongs to you.
And that is Chromir.
As the great explosion filled the region, my father cast a rune at the great hammer that it might not be had by our enemies. It was with his final act. Chromir, I thank you, Joachim. I hadn't dared hope it still existed. It shall soon see glorious battle once again. We welcome the opportunity to fight by your side, mighty Thorim. I must return to Dun Niflheim. We shall speak again soon, Stormlord.
Okay, so that is Chromir. For all those who were expecting Mjolnir, no. Some things have to change. So now Thorim will give us the next quest.
I am Thorim, Lord of Thunder.
Okay, are you done talking? Cool.
Words cannot express my gratitude, monk. You have served me honorably. Please accept this token of my gratitude.
Alright, so we have the Bracers and the Terrace of the Makers.
It is time, Drakfu. I am prepared to face Loken now. Let us make our way to the Terrace of the Makers and face my brother's forces. The fool will regret ever crossing me.
Complacence heralds your doom, adventure.
Okay, so unfortunately that doesn't put me up to Revered, but I do think that that's the next step in the questing in Stormpeaks. Here's the thing, though. We actually did have a quest given to us by the Brunhildar, and we're actually going to backtrack to that to take care of it, because I do not like having stuff on the other end of the map that we have not completed. So, quick magic cut while we make our way to that area. Okay, so here we are. We actually needed to head out to this little Vrykul settlement out here, which is actually where a lot of Valkyr are. And for people who know the lore behind Sylvanas and also the stuff in Stormheim, that actually deals a lot with Valkyr. And so we have entered Valkyrian. Now we have a couple of targets here. We need to take care of some Frost Oil. And also some nascent Valkyr need to be killed. And then also we need to take care of their leader. But I can't remember how you get the Frost Oil. Do you just kill the Valkyr for it? I don't know. There we go. So we killed them. Now, while I'm getting this done, it's only appropriate now that we actually get into a questing break. So, go! Okay, so we've taken care of all of the minor stuff. Let's go ahead and take care of Yolda, the Storm Speaker, who seems to be the leader out here.
Hello there! Boom! You're done.
Oh, we have another quest. A harpoon crate. Valkyrian must burn. The crate is filled with incendiary harpoons. You recall seeing harpoon guns and dry stacks of hay outside. Perhaps Ivel will appreciate the extra effort and reward you appropriately. Okay, so we actually need to start up some fires.
Fire? Oh no!
And so now we have an incendiary harpoon. I'm gonna bring it out to the... Oh, never mind. Maybe I can just use it. Okay. So you'll notice all of these hay bales right here. I believe this is how you use it. Oh, wait, hold on. Why is it not working? Okay. Did I not grab the right thing? I don't know. Okay. No, it should be working. So we just need to start up 6 fires. I could have sworn it was with the hay, but... Okay, maybe I'm doing it wrong? I don't know. Maybe I'm going to the wrong height. Tell you what, I'm going to magic out really quick while I figure this out. Oh, there we go. Never mind. We have to use the harpoon guns. Yay. So, boom. That's one fire started. Let's see. Can we hit the next one? That might be right. Boom! We're starting fire. I don't care what you do, Miss Valkyr, because I will kill you as soon as I get this. Oh, did I not get it? Oh, that's not cool. Well, let's hit that one. Will that work? Yay! Okay, so now that we've taken care of all of the tasks, let's go ahead and fly back to the Brunhildar. So magic up while we do that. Okay, so we're back at Brunhildar Village. Let's go ahead and turn these quests in. We've been such a nice person, haven't we? Oh, yeah, it does actually put you back in the disguise. My bad. Somebody actually did prove that to me. Okay, so let's talk to Thirva. Or Thira.
You have our thanks, sister. We cannot allow our valiant traditions to be corrupted.
Okay. And Iva the Vengeful. We have three quests to turn, and off with their black wings.
The Valkyr are nothing but the Lich King's lapdogs. They will be put down like the scum they are. They've made their choice. Now they have to live with the consequences.
We can get a fist weapon, and it is kind of better than one of the maces I have, but I don't want to go back to fist weapons. That's a thing. Let's see what we can make work. Yulda's Folly.
Yulda had it coming. No one gets away with insulting the Hildsmeet, not even one of our own.
Okay. And then finally, Valkyrian must burn.
Now that is what I call dedication. Those traitors might have a new master now, but they'll never forget their sister's parting gift.
All right. And not really an upgrade. Okay, cool. So we got all those quests taken care of. So the next step that I actually want to take care of is heading back to the Gromar crash site. So magic up while we do that. Okay, we are back at the Grummarsh crash site. The reason I wanted to come back here is because I wanted to turn in the Relics of Olduar quest really quick before we start doing work for them. And let's go ahead and turn in with Olet.
Blood and thunder.
Were you able to find the relics of which I spoke?
Yes, I was. They're really handy.
These will do nicely. I am much obliged. Perhaps a drink for your troubles.
And he lets us pick an ale of some kind, whatever. Just pick one. Okay. So let's go ahead and take care of his quest, starting with the missing Bronzebeard, because I want to actually try and get this quest done for you guys. This is actually another big portion of the Stormpeaks quest line, specifically for the Alliance too, because you get to have the return of an old friend. The missing Muradin Bronzebeard, who's actually been missing since Warcraft 3. And if we were playing Alliance, then you could actually see like what happened to Muradin, but unfortunately it doesn't really show here. So all we have to do is go down here. There's a little iron rune dwarf. There's also a disturbed snow, which has my burlap wrapped note. So we'll go ahead and grab that. And then the other thing I want to take care of is the emergency measures, which is the warg fur, which I believe I can just do in this area. But I can't remember off the top of my head. Now we're actually like in the middle of Titan structure, so you'll be able to see a lot more Titan stuff. That was a cool part to see back in the day, was the Engine of the Makers just going down there and seeing what the crap is down there. That was awesome. Is it in the cave? Could be in the cave. It's either in the cave or it's up in the Terrace of the Makers. I'm hoping it's not up there. That would be a problem. And, oh, by the way, Lich Broom. Take that. No, Jormungandr worms are in there, so we're not going to worry about that. I'll bet it's up in the Terrace of the Makers. Oh, and Ice Thorn. Let's grab that, too. Yay. Now we're high enough that we're actually getting Ice Thorn, not the brambles. And a bunch of blue proto drakes. That's not good. So welcome everybody to the Terrace of the Makers. We'll be doing some questing a little bit later with Thorim, but yeah, it's pretty much under siege. As you can see, the Earthen fighting off against the Iron Rune Dwarves. And right now we actually need to take care of some warg fur. Probably in the mountain areas. I don't know, maybe it is in the cave. The cave had worms in it, but we can at least check the cave. Let's see, so Hmm, okay. It does say a cave dweller warg, so let's go in here. Oh, we actually have a quest to turn in here. Well, look at that. Here's our missing tracker. So let's go ahead and talk to him.
Talk to me.
Oh, this hurts bad, man. Don't know if I'm gonna make it.
Cave medicine. It's good to see a friendly face. Might be the last one I see. One of those Yomanga stumped me with some sort of toxin before I managed to get away. I can feel my whole body getting numb, man. I'm going to need a toxin gland to make an antidote. I'll also need some of the cave mushrooms that grow here. They'll slow the toxin down. Hurry, please. I don't have much time.
Oh, and speaking of wards. Okay, so we need warg fur, we need mushrooms, and then we also need a gland from the Ormonger. Oh no, and I finally hit that point. Dang it. Okay. Well, really quick, let's step out, and we'll drain our inventory. And then we'll come back into the cave, because that's what we do. There we go. Oh, and there's our toxin gland. So we already have that. This is one of the advantages of having this, and when you can afford it, I suggest you do. There we go. Okay, so now that we still have some mushrooms and other things to grab, questing break, go! That took a while, but we finally found all our warg fur. Okay, let's go ahead and turn this in with the tracker and get that medicine in his system.
What you want?
You back, man.
Yes, and I brought what you needed.
I thank you, man. I might live another day now.
There's always time for revenge. I should manage for now, Drakfu. There is one favor I'd like to ask, though. I would never have fallen to one of these worms, but my wind serpent, Hisha, was killed by the meanest warg I've seen in some time. Don't worry about me now. I'll feel better when the warg is breathing no more. You should find them deeper in the cave.
So we actually have to kill Gimmerak, who people might have noticed. I've actually killed him a couple of times in the questing break, so let's go ahead and go back down and grab him.
Let's do this.
Okay.
So deeper and deeper into the cave we go. Let's use some rolls and whatnot to get me there quicker. So we can take care of Gimmerak and then move on. Oh, look, more warg. Now the warg are starting to respawn. Okay, so this is the room where Gimmerak is supposed to be. Oh, now we have patrols. Okay.
That's even better.
Let's roll over and kill Gimmerak. Hey, Gimmerak! I'm here to kill you again!
Thank you! Okay. We're moving on now.
Okay, do we turn it in with the hunter? We might. Okay. Let's take care of that, and then we will head back to the Grommarsh crash site. Turn in more quests. Oh, I don't care about you guys. Okay, so further up the cave we go. And just as a reminder, feel free to tune in later this afternoon today. So not only will the Tale of Drakfu go up today, but also later in the afternoon will be the third episode of Why We Geek. So all the people who keep on asking me, when's the next episode of Why We Geek? Today. I just told you, today. So you guys can check that out. And it is going to be in honor of the upcoming Power Rangers movie. It's going to be a Power Rangers episode. So you guys can enjoy that. And here's the tracker. So let's go ahead and turn this into him.
Who you be?
I'm already feeling much better, man. Not sure if it's the antidote or the news of that filthy war getting what he deserved.
Okay. Oh, this is actually a big improvement agility-wise. So we're going to take that. Actually, I never checked out those bracers that Thorim gave me.
Do I still have them? Let's see here. I'm sure I do. I just don't know where they got put in my... Oh, here it is. So, the Stormweather cuffs, are they an improvement? Not really. I go down a little bit in stamina, but that's about all that happens. One point of critical strike is not necessarily worth it to me. All right, let's go ahead and get out of the cave here. And head back over to the Grawmarsh crash site. Which thankfully isn't too far off, but now... Oh, come on. I'm like literally... Oh, I'm in combat, that's why. Are you really gonna make me do this? Okay. Give me all my proto drake. There we go! So, the crash site should be the... Oh, wrong one. There we go. Oh my gosh, and I just barely looked at the experience bar. We're about to hit 84. Jiminy Christmas, man. Well, I'm gonna be capped for Cataclysm, so we'll be able to brush through that content fairly quick. And then we'll cap for Pandaria, and then and everything will work out just fine. Okay, let's go ahead and turn in all of this stuff. So, first of all, with Bloodguard Lorga. Look,
did you bring the furs?
Yes, I did. They were hard to get.
These furs are rather large. I'd hate to see the wargs you had to face off with. We're all very thankful. The temperature is starting to drop already.
Okay, and we can get some bracers that are not an improvement. Okay, and then finally, we can turn this in with Bokhtar Blood Fury.
Did you have any luck finding Bronzebeard's camp?
We found a camp.
Of course, with our luck. I could have probably predicted this. Well, we're not going to let him get away that easily. Let's see what that note says.
Okay. The nose knows.
In order to track down Bran, we're going to need a creature with a keen sense of smell and a good tracking ability. There weren't any hounds on the Zeppelin, but I think I have a substitute. After the crash, I send Khaleesi down the...
Khaleesi. I think that's how you say it.
I sent Khaleesi down to the east face of the mountain to start hunting for food. Her cat, Frostbite, excels at tracking prey in the snow. Tell her that she'll have to part with her companion for a while, at least. So she can hunt on her own, but we have no other way of catching up to Bran Bronzebeard.
Cool. Oh, so yeah, we're hunting Bran, not necessarily Muradin. But Muradin is something that you deal with in the Alliance portion of this, is that you actually meet a Muradin who doesn't remember who he is. This is probably Bran trying to find Muradin, aka the greatest archaeological find that he's ever had. Okay, so go down here. And we need to find the hunter that has Frostbite. So, Frostbite the kitty, not Frostbite the disease. Here we are. So here is Khaleesi. Oh, jeez. Okay.
What business have you?
So, Bokhtar has volunteered Frostbite for an errand, eh? Well, this had better be important. He knows better than to try to separate a hunter from her pet.
I know. Don't kill me, please. Sniffing out the perpetrator.
Bokhtar can have his way this time, but I'll expect him to make it up to me. Don't look at me like that. Bokhtar may be in command, but no one tells a hunter what to do. Put that beast away, he says. Make it stop growling. All of a sudden, he changes his mind when it suits him. Next time he complains, Frostbite'll just nip him a bit. Don't worry, she'll do an admirable job tracking your prey. After she locates her target, you're on your own to deal with Iron Dwarves or Bran or whatever you find.
We will have justice.
Okay, so we actually need to take Frostbite with... And there we go, the Iron Dwarves followed you. Use the net and Ice Slick to escape. Oh, noes! What on earth are we going to do? Oh, there it is. Okay. Okay, well, take care of that. Oh, this is very much like the Grizzly Hills quest that the Alliance gets that I wanted to show you guys. Which is us running away from Morgan. But, unfortunately, we weren't so lucky. That's okay, though. Ooh, we're gonna deal with a lot of rhinos now. Oh, no, he's back on our tail! Don't hit Frostbite! Oh, big proto-drakes off in the distance. No, screw you. You get netted, because that's how much I care for you. Do we have dwarves? Yes, we do. Take that net. Frostbite, you can find this guy whenever you want. That's okay. Take that net. I'm holding off on the ice slick because I have a feeling we're going to get more enemies as we go along. Oh, here's a cave. Track the so investigate the cave. All right. And we come across Tracker Thulin. So we need to take care of him. Boom. And we get Brand's Communicator. So let's go ahead and turn this in. I think back at the crash site. Or maybe not. Maybe we use Brand's Communicator. Attempt to contact Brian Bronzebeard. There we go. So we get a little hologram of him.
The answers are here. I can feel.
An image of a dwarf appears as you activate the communicator. It can only be Brian Bronzebeard. From the look on his face, Bram seems shocked to see you and begins gesturing furiously. All right, speak Orcish, man. Bran begins gesticulating wildly and rambling in his native language. That's the best I can do, guys.
Cosmodan, cost. Amados, Hine, Mita.
I'm not even going to try and pronounce this because I'm going to get it wrong. Magita Rook. After a few moments, you realize the conversation is going nowhere. Perhaps the shaman, Mota Windborn at the Grommash crash site will know what to do.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Okay, so I'm only guessing he was saying horrible things about my mother. Because that's usually how dwarves go. Holy crap, I went from 90% to 98. I am definitely going to ding. And I'm going to be 84. I'm going to be 85 by the time. Like, I pretty much guarantee Ice Crown will ding me, and then I'll be 85. And by the time we go into Cataclysm content, I will be capped. All right. Well, that makes things a lot easier now, doesn't it? So back to the crash site we go. Let's go ahead and turn this into the shaman. I'm probably saying the name wrong.
Bokhtar will not be happy that you didn't find Bran, but at least you didn't come back empty-handed. Now let's see what we can do about this babbling dwarf.
Okay. 2,000 quests completed. Yep. Speaking with the wind's voice,
I suppose we shouldn't have expected to find Bran so easily, not with our luck. If we can make sense of what Bran is saying, you can persuade him to give up his location. The power of the wind is strong in these mountains, and it may prove a great boon to us. A knowledgeable shaman can hear the sound of all the world's tongues on the wind. To the northwest on the snowdrift plains, you will find beings made of wind, the Storm Riders. Capture their voices and bring them to me. Go in.
So one question I have in the middle of all this. Blood Elves used to be part of the Alliance, which makes sense that Blood Elves would be able to understand Dwarvish. I get that it's a mechanic in Warcraft that you can't understand what the other is saying, but I think they overlooked that when they made this quest, because it's like, we're formerly High Elves. We can understand the language. Okay, whatever. And unfortunately, we've actually hit that time once again, so I'm going to have to go ahead and call it for this week. When we get back, we will finish up Storm. We are going to finish up Storm Peaks next week and move on into the Ice Crown Glacier. In the meantime, though, like I said, check out this afternoon for Why We Geek, and later on this evening for the next episode of Geek News, Reviews, and Opinions. Until then, we'll see you guys next time.